joining us at home live on Sky Sports Fight Night. We're in the first direct arena, Eddie Hearn from Matchroom Boxing is proud to bring you the featured bout of the evening, the main event, 12 rounds for the WBC International Featherweight Crown. We are proudly sponsored by William Hill, by StubHub, and by Scott's Menswear. All our officials appointed by the British Boxing Board of Control and the World Boxing Council. Here for the board, Mr. Alistair Hayes, supervising for the WBC, Senor Mauro Betti. Our three scoring judges, from Scotland, Mr. Victor Loughlin. From the USA, Mr. John McKay. And from Mexico, Senor Juan Carlos Pelayo. On the bell, timekeeper Peter Humphrey. When the bell rings, referee in charge from England, star referee Mr. Ian John-Lewis. And so, ladies and gentlemen, in attendance here at ringside, the officials are ready. The boxers are ready. Are you ready for the main event? Introducing in the red corner, the challenger. Wearing red with black and white trim, on the scales, nice on 2.6 ounces. He brings a record of 33 contests, 31 wins, 15 outside the distance, only 2 defeats. He is a former Irish champion, former world title challenger from Dublin, Ireland, Patrick Badger the Punisher Highland. And in the blue corner, with head trainer Sean O'Hagan. He is the champion. From 23 contests, 23 wins, 4 wins inside the distance. Former English, British, Commonwealth and European champion. Tonight, making the third defense of his title, the reigning WBC International Featherweight Champion, the fighting pride of Leeds, Yorkshire, the undefeated Leeds Warrior, Josh.
Dressing room, and by my command at all times, the background of the rules was to hit, kick the punches up, and when our shout break, you break clean. And remember, defend yourselves at all times. Shake hands.
Touch of the gloves between the two. There's been a lot of respect shown between them in the build up to this fight. It was always going to be that kind of encounter. As I mentioned, Highland has wanted this fight for some time. Warrington would be a significant scalp. Forget about the weight issues, that's in the past now. If he could get the win here, then it will mean a lot for his career after that defeat against Gary Russell Jr. That was his first fight under Pascal Collins, his trainer. He's operating out of the Celtic Warriors gym. Warrington looking for the jab, and everybody's assuming that these two are going to stand in front of each other. When I spoke to Highland the other day, he suggested that maybe that's kidology, maybe that isn't what he's going to do, but the early signs are that that is probably what is going to happen.
Yeah, it looks that way already. Highland looks to mean business. The jab's been working excellently in this short time this fight's commenced. And that's from Warrington, who was very, very sharp, knocking that head back time and again with that excellent jab. And he's given away height and reach.
Good jab again there from Warrington. As I said, he was thinking that he might be over in Germany, in the USA, on the undercard of Arthur Abraham's recent fight, or Andre Ward's forthcoming fight, just a different kind of experience. He's been over to Germany once before, just to try and keep busy. And he's ended up with another outing in front of this Leeds crowd, which for him will never, ever never get old. There is, of course, a burden of expectation, if you like, when you have this much support. It's a lot to live up to, but he's made a good start here. Good snappy jabs followed by the right man, then looks to finish with the left to the body there, Warrington.
But so far we've seen Highland very straight up, very upright, and getting caught fairly easily from a very sharp Josh Warrington. Started excellently here. Timing is really on the money.
Highland's dream scenario is that he wins, and fellow Irishman Carl Frampton wins later on against Leo Santa Cruz, and those two can then get it on. But there's a lot that needs to happen for that to materialise, and Warrington just looking to tenderise Highland to the body as well.
Yeah, the very best of luck to Carl Frampton out there. Big job at hand, but let's hope he can do well.
Warrington with some wide cup and blows. He's not finding Highland to be a difficult target to locate at the moment.
You can see why Gary Russell found Highland easy to hit and got rid of him in excellent fashion. He is very straight up and down, needs to move that head, different side to side a little bit to miss some of the punches.
Well, the boxing news reports of that Highland's Gary Russell fight said that Highland wasn't outclassed. He was in the wrong school, which seems harsh, but when you watch it, the evidence speaks for itself. Gary Russell, a special fighter, as we head to the end of this first round, which has been a good one for Warrington.
He's throwing jab right hand over top. Make him throw that right hand over his body. Okay. So do all your work from this side of him.
Come on, 10 seconds.
Well, very good start. Look at those straight punches, left and right. Body shot getting in well.
Second out,
also from Warren, excellent start from the local lad.
Highland looking for the right hand to the body. He's been sparring Stephen Ormond. His gym mate was accompanied into the ring by Spike O'Sullivan, another fighter from the Celtic Warriors gym.
He's splendidly dressed as well, old Spike. Really looking the part.
He kind of always looks slightly like a Prohibition-era gangster to me, Spike O'Sullivan, the way he's turned out, but he takes a lot of care of the appearance.
A great guy, great, great guy.
Highland trying to use that jab a bit more in the opening stages of this second round, Warrington just having a look here. The corner were telling him, his dad Sean O'Hagan, that he was just dipping a bit too far away to his left-hand side to try and land that left of the body, and was leaving himself a bit open.
Nice right hand there, teed off, timing very good from Warrington. Good defence as well from Warrington, keeps his hands nice and tight. Can the Irishman find a way through? Part of his career in America, Highland.
Solid right hand to the body there from Warrington, and then look to switch up to the head. Highland trying to keep that head on the move. Highland was actually already training for a fight in Dublin that was scheduled for February when he got the call for the Russell fight, which was originally scheduled for March and then went back to April the 16th, which was the same night actually that Warrington was in action against Amagasa, which you would say has been his toughest test so far in terms of the name that he's faced. Amagasa, who managed to put Rigondeaux over a couple of times.
Good hooks there from Warrington. He's getting through with straight punches right down the line and hooks around the side. What can Highland come back with? Good body shot. Going right to the head.
Highland trying to push out that jab. Jab caught on the gloves there by Warrington. Again, just chops down with the right.
Chris Hyland dipped quite low at the waist.
Yeah, Hyland's leaning away from that right hand and in doing so straight under it.
Well, that's the scene at the First Direct Arena, packed as it always is. And they've enjoyed what they've seen so far.
Yeah, good shot going through there. Timing's excellent so far from Warren and putting the combinations down, together.
Three. Interesting times in the featherweight division. I mentioned Frampton, Santa Cruz, Selby is ringside for that one. Oscar Valdez picked up the WBO title in the last couple of weeks after Vasyl Lomachenko vacated it, having won the same title at super featherweight with a pretty extraordinary performance against Rocky Martinez. That's the kind of mix, the kind of company that Warrington is trying to enter. It's built the right way. English, followed by Commonwealth, followed by British, then European. Everybody knows what the next logical step is.
Yep, and that should come soon enough for first business here. Just got to get this out of the way. Highlander, a lot of fights, 33. Only lost two of those. So good record. Knows what he's doing in there.
And only lost to good fighters as well. We mentioned Rossi, but the other one is Javier Fortuna, who somewhat unexpectedly lost his WBA super featherweight title to Jason Sosa a few weeks ago. But Fortuna, a good fighter, and he's been caught here, Highlands. Warrington again with some good work there, but he's not really showing so far any ill effects from it. But he has been, well, so far he's a bit too easy to hit, Patrick Highland.
Yeah, he certainly is. He can't go many rounds getting hit like this, because he's finding it fairly comfortable to get through that defence of Highlands. Warrington,
the Leeds version of the Viking clap that we saw so much of at Euro 2016, just echoing around the hall. He's just been beaten to the punch here, Highland, beaten to the jab. He's trying to feint with his front foot, then step in with the jab down. The wrong team is already moving away towards the neutral corner. Left hand there from Warrington. Maybe for the line low, but that's a good combination, putting four, five punches together there.
Yeah, that's class, isn't it? You know, he is improving with every fight, getting more and more confidence in his punch power, his accuracy's getting better. And, you know, I'm really looking forward to him to get that world title fight. He's worked long and hard and picked up all the belts that he needs to. Is it going to be Lee Selby or Gary Russell, or who will he get? Lucky Collins there, brother Steve Collins in the corner, giving instructions, good trainer in Dublin, trying to get Highlander work to the body a little bit. He wants to get a shot right through the middle of the defense. That's what he's asking for.
Round four.
They want Highland to drive that left hand in. That's what they're looking for, that's what they've been asking for. It's been Warrington's fight so far. Company to the ring by Isaac Lowe, that's who we've been working with mainly in preparation. He was helping Lowe prepare for his fight, his potential fight actually. He was supposed to be in the undercard of Fury Klitschko on July the 9th. It didn't happen, as we all know. So he was already in good shape, Warrington, when he discovered that this fight was in the offing. Highland trying to land that backhand that came from a long way back. Warrington got that left glove up.
A little more success with the jab, Highland.
One shot!
jabbing to the body.
It's important that Warren doesn't forget his jab. He's had very good success with it. He needs to remember that shot. Another right hand. Nice combination.
Left hook and then followed by left to the body there. Ireland almost turning his back a touch.
Yeah, it was Warren that was looking to get that body punch in.
Was looking to let that uppercut go. Was quickly back into his shell again. Looks for the left of the body there. Lands with the right hand. Highland just in the crouch, looking to try and shoot that jab upwards if he can.
Well, if you want to make a statement here, I think it's important for Warren to do that. Good combination going in.
He was a bit disappointed with the performance against Amagasa. He felt he switched off in the middle rounds, Warrington, and gave a couple away. He was quite downbeat in the interview afterwards. He knows that he keeps having to raise things a notch every time he gets in the ring. Ideally, it doesn't always turn out that way, of course, but Highland again just dipping at the waist and almost bringing himself on to punches there. Good defence there, though, from Highland on the ropes. Back to the ropes, just ushering Warrington in, rolling the shoulders, catching punches.
A smile there across his lips, Highland. Good spirit in this fight.
So that chin can't come over that knee, you understand me?
Yes.
Yeah.
So far, so good for Josh Warrington, through four rounds against Patrick Highland, who came in heavy yesterday, the weigh-in, 2 pounds, 6 ounces. He was over, had 2 hours to lose that, elected not to make the attempt. The weight issue is an interesting one, because if he's worked really hard to get down even that close, which he may well have done, then any further attempt could just weaken him to the point where it would be detrimental to his health. But mind games can come into it. There can be a bit of kidology involved. You just never really know, do you?
Yeah, there could be. I mean, he might have elected just to thought, you know what, I'm going to try and just have a little slight advantage. I'm sure he would have, you know, if I'm one, I'm sure he would have, Pycons would have tried to made the weight. They just haven't gotten it right often. You know, the last 2 days are vital when you cut your fluids a little bit and you try and dehydrate to get yourself right down. Often that's when mistakes can be made.
There's that left hand that Paddy Collins was talking about between rounds a couple of rounds ago. Just managed to dip to his left and throw it that time, Highland. Warrington looking for the jab. And the pace has just dropped slightly in the opening minute of this fifth round. Warrington looking to pick it back up again now.
Yeah, nice accurate overhand right from Warrington again. He's finding Highland still fairly easy to hit, but Highland still, he's taken them well. Hasn't been looking uncomfortable in any way so far.
Warrington looking to thud in those body shots. Will they have an effect as we head into the later rounds, possibly? But you're right, Highland hasn't looked in any kind of discomfort. There's been no visible reaction to anything that's landed on him from Warrington, who just looks to get those feet moving, bouncing on the balls of his feet. Into the final minute of round five, the Leeds crowd just looking to raise Warrington again. That strong connection, of course, with Leeds United, walked in by their captain, Sol Bamba.
Well, he's doing everything right. You can't really fault Josh Warrington. Winning every round on my card, looking comfortable, looking sharp.
It's a combination there from Warrington. The left at the start of it to me looks a little bit low, but I mean, John Lewis had a better view of it than I did. Stop,
Well, you can tell just by the work rate of Josh Warrington that he, you know, he works so hard in the gym. It doesn't look like he leaves anything to chance. And that's what you need to if you're going to get to the very highest level.
Well, no longer working as a dental technician. He got up a while ago.
It's Warrington, accurate on the front foot, Highland against the ropes, getting caught with good shots, good combinations from the lead boxer, who's really got the crowd on their feet, loving every second of his performance, as they always do. It really is a terrific atmosphere here.
Keep on the outside panel. If you get inside, move your hand out of this. You've got to go back into the shots, okay? Step around them. Okay, now you start stepping up with it, all right?
Back in that shot, step on it. Okay, guys, 10 seconds. Use your feet to distance him, Joshua.
Oh, boy.
Use your feet to distance him.
Seconds out, round six.
Round six is scheduled. 4:12, the WBC International Featherweight title, which is currently held by Josh Warrington. Won it against Dennis Tuburon and has defended twice against Joel Brunker and then against Hisashi Amagasa. Pascal Collins trying to keep his man going, keep him positive in the corner there. Learned his trade under the Petronelli's, the old trainers of Marvin Hagler. Steve Collins, of course, spent a lot of time in the United States during his career. Left hand there from Warrington landed pretty flush, and then just using that front foot to dart in and out of the touch and chop it down with the right hand. He does dip away a long way to his right hand side, Highlands.
Yeah, he leaves himself wide open when he does that, doesn't he? For that chopping punch that comes in from Warrington. Again, this time followed up by a left hook.
And again, left to the body, followed by a left to the head. 3-4 punch combinations he's putting together. Good long backhand there as well from Warrington. Gotten through, he's picked it up in round six. It didn't really drop too much in round five, but he's put a lot into the opening 90 seconds of this round.
Yeah, nice accurate right hand, just behind that elbow of Highlands there. The accuracy's good, there's not a lot to criticise. He's jabbing well, his work rate's good, defence is good, improving all the time.
That's a lovely stiff jab there from Warrington, and again as Highland just dips away to his right, he chops down with that right hand. He's been fairly accurate with it, the right hand slightly high on the head of Highland. I thought he was staggered there maybe for a second. It was towards the kind of temple area, but Highland again just nods his head, keeps coming forward.
Yeah, terrific volley of punches though, wasn't it? Every one super accurate. And Ian John Lewis just needs to keep a little eye out here as these punches are going in, because they're going in big combinations. And that's where, you know, Highland could get hurt with one, and there's a quick two or three in rapid succession, so Ian John Lewis needs to be attended.
There's that jab again, just reached for it a bit with the second one. The first landed nicely. Highland launching a wide left hand, got caught, and then digs to the body at the end of the round there. Highland, and he's certainly showing how tough he is in there so far, but it's Warrington who, at the moment, is dominating this.
Yeah, he's won well in every round, but that was probably his most impressive round. He got that salvo of punches off. That was very, very impressive. There we go. 6-7. Then right hand, the body, and the eighth over the top. Really good, accurate, hurtful punches. Did well to take them, Highland.
Oh, all they're going to tell him to do now is they're going to tell him to start bringing up a cross and in a body. I think he'll spew it and swallow after another round or so. Don't give him no. He's going to try and move you on the floor. Get that right arm on the door.
Seconds out, round 7.
Into the second half of the schedule for 12, Josh Warrington in the blue, gold and white of Leeds. Patrick Highland in the red, white and black. Highland coming out looking more aggressive at the start of the seventh round. Felt that one of those landed a little bit low, offered the apology to Warrington. It's been that kind of spirit between these two right from the very off.
Yeah, very good spirit. Both nice guys outside the ring. But I think Patty Collins worried his man starting to take too many, like give him orders to go out and, you know, give it a good round.
Left from Warrington was right on the belt, and Highland had to get on with things there because he just span around, and as he did so, Warrington was right back in front of him and throwing.
Highland bravely comes roaring back, trying to let shots go to the body, but he is taking some pretty sickening punches to the head and in good combinations. Tough and proud man, though. As we said, only 2 defeats in 33 fights. He'll want to see the final bell.
Warrington, as we know, hasn't scored too many stoppage wins in his career, just 4 in his 23 victories. But that often is largely to do with who you're up against. It can earlier in your career particularly be difficult to get fighters out of there if they've come to survive. And you wonder at what point. Highland just turning southpaw now. This is new. We haven't seen this in the fight so far.
No, I think he's running out of ideas. This kind of looks to me and going to try anything now.
Back to orthodox, and as he completed the switch, his hands were down and Warrington capitalised on it.
Well, he has done so many times, hasn't he? Really is finding it difficult to miss.
Landed it, that one taken on the shoulder.
Well, it's been another very good round for Josh Warrington. Scored a lot of punches. Highland trying to bring out some resistance, but getting caught an awful lot. It's a good job he's not a real big puncher. I'm sure he wishes he was, Warrington, but for Highland's sake. Here he is on the attack again, letting punches go both hands. Really is fit. And he likes to throw them combinations. They just go off. I mean, it's a good performance, this, from Josh Warrington. Doing everything right, impressing. This is exactly what he wants to do. I'm sure he'd love to get the stoppage zone.
Round 8, Pascal Collins just telling Highland there, let the shots go, it doesn't matter if they land, just let them go. But he needs to make Warrington work a bit more. When I heard that first comment, I did wonder if that's the kind of remark you might make when you're just asking a fighter for a bit more, for maybe 1 round, 2 rounds more before you might start to think about pulling him out. It's always a difficult decision to make, and they've had some interesting ones in recent times because Frank Buglioni was with them with Pascal Collins against Tudorov, and They let that go the distance. It was very bruising for Buglioni. Then they pulled Spike O'Sullivan out against Juvan Jr., for example. So it's always a hard one to call.
Yeah, well, Paggy knows his fighter. You know, he knows Highland's tough and game, and I think he'll understand when he's probably had a bit too much. I think he's asking him, he's trying to gauge what he's got left in the tank, if he's got enough to win this, but I don't think you'll want to see him take too many more shots. It's because, you know, I haven't given him a round on my card, Highland, and you just wonder how he's going to win. You don't want to take, you know, you don't want to take too many punches. If you're not going to win a fight, you don't want to take punches just for the sake of it.
And again, just walking around the centre of the ring. Never stays in one place for any particular length of time. Again, the right hand just coming in behind the guard there, and that was a strong shot for Warrington.
I like the way his jabs work. He's very accurate, very precise. Defensively, you know, it's good, not getting hit with a lot. Work rate's very good. A lot to like about Josh Warrington. That's why they love him here.
Well, support is a big thing. Popularity, particularly early in your career, is crucial, really. The ability to sell tickets will always endear you to promoters. If you could sell tickets and you can really fight as well, then that's the dream combination. And he packs this place out every single time. His name was up in lights, and he's looking to try and tee off a little bit on Highland there. He's caught on the ropes. A good smearing left hand there from Warrington.
Dembley's trying to fight back Highland, but he's not really connecting him much at all, is he? You know, he's trying, he's taking shots.
And finally, Highland goes down to a knee, and that was another chopping right hand there from Warrington as Highland dipped away to his right-hand side. It's just the volume of punches really there that has seen him finally go down to that knee, and it was a well-advised thing to do, and it happened right on the bell there. And Warrington just bangs those gloves together as he goes back to the blue corner, and he took a lot of punishment before eventually he dropped down, and they need to have a really good hard look at him here between rounds.
Yeah, I'm not right for one. You know, Paddy Collins knows he's mad, but I for one don't see a great deal of future in this. And I don't think I'd be sending him out of there. You know, he's not my fighter. He's obviously proud and doesn't want to lose, but I don't think I'd send him out. Well, they're gonna. Yeah, he took some thudding punches there. That right hand, which is causing chaos all night long, hasn't it? He's just been wide open for that. So, maybe they're going to give him a little go, see if he's recovered, but I'd have that towel in my hand myself.
Round nine, and Highland's back out to the centre of the ring. With that stance of his, with that weight fairly heavily on the front foot, just trying to keep those gloves up, trying to keep Warrington at bay. But Warrington again just closes in, and Highland goes down to a knee, and there's really no point in this continuing, to be honest. Highland grimaces. He's very, very brave in there. He's taken a lot, and there's just no need to take any more. Pascal Collins is on the apron with the towel in his hand. He's shouting at his fighter, trying to get his attention, and he's just standing square, standing tall, and training now, Patrick Highland. Josh Warrington letting his hands go, and he goes down again to the knee. The towers come in, and the fight is over. Warrington mounts the corner of the ring and celebrates with these Leeds fans, and Pascal Collins has done the right thing. He could maybe have done it a little bit earlier, to be honest, because Highland, he withstood the pressure, he withstood the onslaught for a long, long time in there, and then as soon as he went down once, the floodgates really had opened. It was only a matter of time before he was going to go down again, and he sat on the stool in the centre of the ring having a conversation with the doctor. He looks like he's okay. Warrington celebrating, and We knew that he had to get this job done tonight. We knew that it was still all on the line despite Patrick Hyland coming in over the weight. If he hadn't won tonight, then all those other dreams and aspirations would have gone away. And here's
it showed straight from the start there was nothing in him. He takes the knee. Tower would have went in for me there. But he's allowed to take more punches. Very accurate, Warrington. And he was a beaten man, brave as he is, Patrick Hyland, and proud as he is. He just had to take too many punches against a fighter that was really on fire tonight. Very sharp, very quick, great combinations going on in. And he's getting closer and closer to that world title shot. They let it go on, and he knew that his man was inside, knew that the finish was there, and just a lot of punches. And that's the end.
Well, Pascal Collins was trying to get his attention as he went down to the knee for the second time. He didn't manage to, and he just decided to get back up and trade for one final time, just to stand in front of Warrington, let his hands go, and just see if he could land that miracle Hail Mary punch. But in real life, that doesn't happen. And
no, but look at Hyland. I mean, how hard he was still trying. I mean, right to the very last, he was trying to let one go, wasn't he? But all in all, great performance from Josh Warrington. He goes on and on, bigger and better things.
Well, Lee Selby.
Excellent division, the featherweight division. Lee Selby, you're going to mention. Carl Fratton, good luck to him later on.
Well, Selby is ringside in New York tonight, but that's the fight that Warrington will want. That's the one that's been talked about for such a long time. Let's get the final formal announcement now from our MC, Craig Stephen.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, referee Ian John Lewis will bring together both boxers. As he does so, please, your appreciation for both boxers in the ring. Official time. 45 seconds of round number 9. Referee Ian John Lewis stops the contest. His opinion, Patrick Hyland in no position to continue. The winner, he is still the WBC International Featherweight Champion. He is still undefeated. The Fighting Bride of Leeds, the Leeds Warrior, Josh Warrington.
I suspect when they have the post-fight interview in just a couple of minutes' time, of course, the name of Lee Selby will be mentioned. He is number one contender for Gary Russell Jr.'s WBC title as well, but to take him on, he'd have to travel over to the United States. And let's get a word now with the winner. He is in the ring with Andy Scott.
Josh, sorry to break you away from the photos there. Ninth round stoppage, is that the most accomplished performance of your career to date, do you think?
Yeah, I think so. You know, Patrick's been giving me nightmares for weeks and weeks. I know he's a very tough man and he eats hard. And, you know, the first couple of rounds, I thought, got to keep their hands up and stay switched on. So, yeah, I think the overall performance, the boxing, the shots I picked, I won't make loose. I listened to my corner and paid off in the end.
A lot of pressure on you tonight from a sold-out arena, but also from your wife to be at ringside, who gave you a strict brief of no cuts and no bruises. So is that a thumbs up to her?
Yeah, definitely. She's me rock, you know what I mean? She's absolutely solid all the way through camp and stuff like that, but with bad moods. And that's added pressure, you know, a lot of pressure on me to finish these guys off in front of the crowd. There's a lot of pressure to keep on winning. You know, we're just on the verge of fighting for the world title, so there's a lot of added pressure, but when you get performances like that, pay off and it's worthwhile.
I have to talk to you about Lee Selby, who brought up the wedding and said that the reason that that flight couldn't happen and that ship had sailed was because of the fact that you were, well, you know, getting married to Natasha. Where is that fight and can it be made still in your eyes?
Of course it can, but you know, he's got aspirations of going and conquering world, you know, being, you know, he talks like he's going to unify division in every division, you know what I mean? If he wants it, he can have it. Listen, we wanted the fight end it here before and didn't suit. So, you know, if he wants it, he can have it. But, you know, if he wants to concentrate on being pound for pound, he's not the only route. There's plenty of other options to go down. We've got fans will come anywhere. If we have to go to Cardiff, we'll do it. If we have to go to America, we'll do it. I'd like to punch him in the face if he wants it, like I say.
Grab a quick word with Eddie Hearn. Just clear up that world title picture. The fans here want a world title shot. Josh wants a world title shot. Can you deliver that?
For sure. I disagree with Josh. I think the world title shot should be here in Leeds. You know, he's built a base here for a long time and everybody's supported him. The natural progression now is to fight for a world title. I don't think there's any more steps. You know, he's beat some top world-ranked fighters. He's developed as a fighter. He's got probably the best fan base in the UK. I think Leeds is where the world title shot's got to come. And if Lee Selby wants to fight, he's a great champion. We can do that in November here, no problem at all. You know, and we're ready for that fight. The timing's got to be right. He's built himself perfectly with the team. You know, you don't take shots like that at the wrong time. Now is the right time. Josh Warrington is ready for a world title, and we really want to bring it to Leeds.
Well done to Josh and your team, marching on together.
Yeah, I'll just say a massive thank you to the team. Massive respect to Patrick. Real hard man. Thanks for the fans for turning out in the numbers like they always do. Absolutely brilliant, and let's go get married.
Well done.
Well, Josh Warrington always in control, a dominant performance. How impressive was he tonight, Johnny?
What's happened to Josh Warrington over the last 3 years? All of a sudden, he's turned into a bit of a banger. Of course, the comparisons were...
Well, still only 5 stoppages on his record, but you seriously...